Good morning. Standard 7. We are going to learn physics today. Chapter number 13. Motion and time. In standard 6, you already learn about the different type of motions, like motion in a straight line, which is also known as rectilinear motion. Then you learn about circular motion. Then also you learn about periodic motion and so on, or oscillatory motion. So you are familiar with the word motion. When the objects change the place in the time interval, then you can say that they are in motion, because they are changing place with respect to time. As the time passes, their place are changed. It means that those objects are in motion. Now we learn the different type of motion, like rectilinear or straight line. When a car is moving on a straight road, we can say that it is a rectilinear motion. The blade of the fence, which are moving on a round path in a circle, so its motion is known as circular motion. Then similarly, pedal of the bicycle, wheel of the bicycle are also examples of circular motion. Then the pendulum or the wings of the birds, or when the athlete is running, motion of his hands, they are known as oscillatory motion. And the some motion which repeat after the same interval of the time, then they are known as periodic motion. So there are lots of type of motion you can see around, and you can classify them that it comes in which type of motion. Our earth moves around the sun, our moon moves around the earth, all the planets moving, etc., etc. So there are lots of examples we can see about the motion. Now we know that everybody is not moving same. It means that we know about the fast motion and slow also. Suppose in a competition of running, say 100 meter race, in the 100 meter race, the distance is determined that from starting point to the 100 meter they have to reach. Then how will we decide that which competitor is fastest, which is slower? So here we will see that we have to take a stopwatch, and when they start running from the starting point, we put on it, and then at the end point again we measure the time. Now the competitor, runner, who will take less time to reach that 100 meter mark will be the winner. It means that that runner will be the fastest runner, we can say that. So we can say that when for a distance, when determined distance is fixed, then we determine the speed or the faster or slower by the time. It means that who will take less time is faster and who will take more time to complete the fixed distance is slower. But if distance is not fixed but time is fixed, that you are given 10 minutes of time, then we have to check who is covering more distance in the time interval of 10 minutes. We have to check how much distance are they covering. Who will cover more distance? Obviously, it is the faster one, because as your speed is increasing, you will cover more distance in that given time interval. So here, fast and slow motion can be determined exactly with the help of either the time, if the distance is fixed, and by distance, if the time is fixed. And according to that, we see that different vehicles are running on the road. From that also, we can determine that who is faster, who is slower. We can observe them also, that some of them are overtaking the other vehicles because they are faster than those other vehicles which are slower. And thus, we have understanding the motion, which is faster motion and slower motion. You can see in this book also, there is two pictures. On the top pictures and in the bottom, you will see that the place of different vehicles is shown in two different times. From that also you can easily determine that who has covered more distance, and then it can be the fastest one, and which is very slow also you can determine yourself only by observation here. So now we know that faster and slower. Now we have to learn about the speed of the moving object. How do we determine speed? Because we are familiar with this word speed, but actually what is speed, you don't know. Some of you maybe are knowing about it, but not everybody is. Just we are knowing about that speed means go faster. So what is speed? Because that speed will be very important in the physics. Now we know that we cover some distance in a time of interval, and then the speed is what? That when we the distance covered by an object in unit time is known as its speed. So what is speed? The distance covered by an object in unit time. Unit time can be either 1 second or 1 minute or 1 hour. Depends that in which unit of time we have measured that distance, I mean time. And then in 1 second or in 1 minute or in 1 hour, whatever the distance covered is known as the speed of that object. So we can have a formula also, that speed is equal to distance, total distance covered, or you can just write down first here, distance covered, divided by time taken. Distance covered divided by time taken. Suppose a vehicle covered 100 किलोमीटर डिस्टेंस in 2 hours. Suppose a vehicle covered 100 kilometer distance in 2 hours. So here the time is measured in hour. So we have to count that how much distance is covered in 1 hour, because we have to check the distance covered in unit time. So 1 hour is the unit time here. So we have to write down here that the speed is equal to distance covered divided by time taken. So here you can see that distance is covered how many kilometers? 100 kilometers divided by time taken is 2 hours. So you can cancel here and we get 50 kilometer per hour. That is the unit for the speed. Kilometer then less than hour means kilometer per hour. Per hour means every hour. It means that the speed of that vehicle is 50 kilometer per hour. Now what you will generally notice that when the vehicles are moving on the busy road or a road which have lots of ups and downs, bumps and some distance disturbances are coming, so that time you know that the vehicle cannot travel at the same speed. Sometimes it is faster, sometimes slower, sometimes they see somebody passing from the road, then they have to brake, and therefore every time the speed will not be same. Therefore, sometimes we have to take the word average speed. The formula will be same. We have to just write down average speed is equal to total distance covered divided by total time taken. The average speed means total time, I mean total distance covered divided by total time taken. So that is average speed also we can take, or generally we use the word speed also. So here, as I told you, the speed, you are familiar with this word because when you watch the cricket match, then when the bowler bowled the ball, and then that time they write down that speed of the ball was some kilometer per hour. Similarly, in the vehicles also, there is a device on the all the vehicles, there is a device which is known as speedometer. That also shows that how fast is your vehicle moving, 60, 80, 90, 100, 120 or whatever, you can see on that speedometer also. So here that speedometer also showing you your average speed, then at what speed are you moving. And then it is, so now you are familiar with how the speed is counted. Speed is counted by total distance covered divided by total time taken. So whatever distance is covered from the beginning to the end of the journey and whatever time taken to cover that distance, that ratio, that division is known as the speed of that object, speed of that vehicle or whatever. And then, as I told you, that the unit actually comes later, but I just explained you the unit now also. When it comes back, we will revise that in that time. So now we are familiar with the motion and speed. Now you also, I think, learn about non-uniform or uniform motion. If otherwise we will talk about that also. Uniform motion and non-uniform motion. uniform and non-uniform motion. Now, what is the meaning of that uniform motion and what is non-uniform motion? Sometimes we see that the speed is not a constant, because we see when we see the objects moving, they have, as I already explained you about that also, that if long time, long duration of distance is covering, then that speed is sometimes increasing, sometimes decreasing, because of the obstacles coming in the way. There is some people are moving, crossing the road, or some animals can be on the road, then we have to be safe. Sometimes that bumps are coming. And so, we see that our speed is changing every time. Speed keeps changing. If the speed is keeping changing, speed keeps changing. In the same interval of time, then that the motion is known as non-uniform motion. But if the speed remains the same, speed does not change, at the same time of interval they are covering the same distance, and then those motion is known as uniform motion. So you understand what is uniform motion and what is non-uniform motion. Again, I will explain you. Uniform motion means the motion in which the speed of the object is same at the same time of interval. But generally, there is very rare thing that we will see, or maybe for the only some small time of interval. Suppose we can say that if the straight road is there and there is no traffic, then for some times, only for few minutes or few seconds, it can be the uniform motion. Because generally, we see that it is not possible to have uniform motion every time. But we are having the lots of the examples of that vehicles having non-uniform motion. Because every time, sometimes it goes faster, sometimes we have to press the brake also. So that most of the time we see the non-uniform motion. So uniform motion means speed is same at the same interval of the time, and non-uniform motion means speed is changing in the different time interval is same, but the speed is changing, sometimes more, sometimes less. Here also, when we find that speed of the vehicle is 50 km per hour, it does not mean that every hour it will cover 50 km. That is only the per hour speed is given. It means that sometimes it can be more than 50 km also it can cover if there is no obstacles there. And sometimes if there is lots of obstacles there, then it can cover 48 kilometers, 49 kilometers also. It means that if the average is given, that generally it is covering 50 kilometers per hour. So that is called the average speed also. So now you are familiar with the speed, we are familiar with the motion, different type of motion, uniform motion, non-uniform motion, etc. also. Now we have to just understand about the time. You are familiar with the time, that, and you are understanding the importance of the time also. Now, time. Especially we have to learn about the measurement of the time. Measurement of time. Nowadays it is easier, very easier to measure the time. right? Because we have different type of clocks, watches, smart watches, even in the our cell phone, smartphone, everywhere you can easily find out time, that what is the time now. But think that in the ancient time, when there were no clocks or watches, nothing was there, then how our ancient were deciding times? Now we have time like minute, second, hours, days, year, month, etc., etc. So by looking at that things, we can say that yeah, our week is finished, our month is finished, new year has started, the year is also getting to finish. We know the morning to evening, the one day is finished, because we have different type of devices that can tell us about the time. But in that time, as I told you, our elders, our forefathers, our ancestors, when they don't had clocks, any type of device, then they were deciding time by some natural phenomena, that the periodic motion of that thing, they were deciding the time. For example, they noticed that sun is rising every morning, means same time, and then it sets, and next day again the same time the sun is rising. So now they decided that from one sunrise to the other sunrise, that time interval is repeating periodically, and therefore they decide that that is the one day, time of one day. It was not exactly same like 24 hours that we don't know now, because sun rising time also little changing every time, but approximate it is equal to the 24 hours. And therefore in that time they see that first sunrise to the second sunrise, they count it as one complete day. Similarly, they see the moon. We know the phases of moon. And now that moon also every 30 days it completes its phases. So from the new moon day to another new moon day, they were counting as one complete month, because moon completes that phases nearly in 30 days. And therefore they decided, they noticed that whole month that there is a new moon day coming shorter, then like that. No, first new moon day means small moon, then it is increasing, and then on the 15th day full moon day, then again it is decreasing, and then again it disappears. So that days of interval they take as the one month. Similarly for the year, what did they decide? How did they decide one year? Then they observe about the seasons, because the seasons also come every year at the nearly same time of interval. Nowadays it is changed because of the pollution, we know that, but that time there was not much pollution because of no vehicles and that. And therefore the season changing was a periodic time, periodic motion that was that time. So that time they were notice the season changing, winter to winter or spring to another spring. They decided that one as a complete year, and so on. So that time there was no device, and therefore they have to depend upon the natural phenomena. And as I told you that from one sunrise to next sunrise they taken as one day. Similarly, new moon day to another new moon day, they taken as one month. hand, when the seasons are changing and the same season coming back, that time interval they took as the complete year. Now year also taken like by Earth to complete the one revolution of the sun. Complete one revolution of the sun is also taken as the time 1 year. Now here we see that in the ancient in the modern time, now we have lots of type of motions, I mean the measuring device for the time are there. Now what is the time is taken as, now it means that how they decide the time. To understand that we have to first understand about the simple pendulum. We have to understand about simple pendulum. Pendulum is just a device in which a thread or a rope is fixed, and then at the end of that some like stone or a metal ball is suspended. That is known as a simple pendulum. It is known as simple pendulum. And then a pendulum is doing the periodic oscillatory motion. It means that if you hold that one and taken one side and then you fall freely for it, then what will happen? It will go like this. It will go thus, coming back, coming go, like that. And that is a periodic motion. Just like you see the motion of the swing. And then, and according to that, the simple pendulum, here the simple pendulum is, here the suspended thing is known as the bob. It is known as bob. So as bob is moving, it is a periodic motion. And according to that periodic motion, they have made the different type of watches. Here the pendulum is said to be completed one oscillation when its bob starting from the mean position, means this is the mean position. It goes one side, come back, go to the other side and come back. Then it is known as one oscillation. Or it is like from, if you start from here, it goes there and come back here. Means wherever you start, come back to that same position, and that time is known as the one oscillation of the motion. Then we have to, one oscillation is called its time period. So time taken by the pendulum to complete one oscillation is known as time period. Means from here, go there, come back. That is known as the time period of it. And further we will look in the second session. Now if you have any query, any confusion, they can, then you can mention it in the comment, then I can give you the answers for that comment. Thank you very much.